Number 4. The solutions to x over 1 minus x less than or equal to 1 are A, B, C or D. Okay, this is an extension 1 topic. It's not in the 2, it's not a harder one. So this is a quite important one to be able to do. Now, here, because we've got this minus in the bottom, what I want to do now is that could be positive or negative. So if I'm multiplying both sides by a negative number, I'll have to change this around. To avoid this, I'm going to multiply both sides by the square of this denominator here. So we shall do that. So I'll write this a different color actually so you can see what's going on. So we'll just set that up like that. I'm going to write that as 1 minus x all squared this side by the same. See, that won't affect that inequality sign because this is going to be positive. Now then, that allows me to simplify the left hand side because that will cancel with one of these. I'll have simply x instead of 1 minus x all squared is less than or equal to, beg your pardon, this will be 1 minus x all squared on this side. Just rub that out. Here we go. Okay, now what I'm going to do, take this across the other side. Doing this. Okay, x outside of 1 minus x. Now I'm just going to take this across this side, making it working from the left hand side. 1 minus x all squared minus x. 1 minus x is greater than or equal to 0. Now taking out the 1 minus x, the common factor, we're going to have here now a 1 minus x there, and here this will be a minus x. See that? Common factor there, leaving with 1 minus x inside, and this one's gone, so we've got the minus x. So this becomes 1 minus x, 1 minus 2x. Is greater than or equal to 0. So on our number line, we have a 1, so that'll make it a 0, it's a critical value of 1. And this, of course, to make that 0, that'll be a half. Now, if you remove those brackets, you would have got a positive x squared. So if you do a little graph of this, a little parabola, actually the parabola would go this way. You can test the regions if you like. This is quite a neat way of doing it. And that's going to be greater than. It's going to be above there and there. So this means that x must be less than or equal to a half. Or x has got to be greater than but not equal to 1. Why? Because back up here, 1 is not defined because that'll make that a 0 there. So just watch that. Just leave off that equal sign there. So the solutions are x less than a half, this one, or greater than 1. So that would be was the answer.